हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम दीपक उनियाल एंड आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट माय फर्स्ट यूट्यूब ट्यूटोरियल ऑन ऑब्जेक्ट ओरिएंटेड प्रोग्रामिंग सिस्टम यूजिंग सी प्लस प्लस। द मोटिवेशन बिहाइंड दीज वीडियोस आर दोज स्टूडेंट्स हू फाइंड वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू अंडरस्टैंड द कॉन्सेप्ट इन क्लासरूम्स एंड आर वेरी हेजिटेंट टू आस्क द क्वेश्चंस। सो आई वुड सजेस्ट देम टू प्लीज रिवाइज द कॉन्सेप्ट मल्टीपल टाइम्स एंड आई एम श्योर दे विल डू वेरी गुड एट प्रोग्रामिंग। सो लेट अस स्टार्ट टुडेज टॉपिक, ऑब्जेक्ट ओरिएंटेड प्रोग्रामिंग सिस्टम। सो एज द नेम सजेस्ट, वी आर डीलिंग विद ऑब्जेक्ट्स और आई कैन से ऑब्जेक्ट ओरिएंटेड प्रोग्रामिंग सिस्टम इज अ प्रोग्रामिंग पैराडाइम विच इज बेस्ड ऑन कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट्स। So the first thing that comes to our mind, what is an object? If we are talking about the programming system that is based on objects, so what is an object? Object is something that is a real world entity and it consists of attributes and behaviors. These two things combine and make an object. Let us try to take an example through which we can identify what are the attributes and what are the behaviors. Suppose there is a car and I talk about attributes of a car. So I can say, let us first define what I mean by attributes, then we'll take an example. What do you mean by an attribute? So attribute is nothing but features of object, or I can say property of object. Another thing that I want to discuss is behavior. When I am talking about object, so an object would like to perform some task, and the task that is being performed by object is called behavior. Now take the example of car and try to define these two things. What attributes or what features could a car have? A car could have features like miles driven. How many miles a car has driven till now, or its current speed, or I can say top speed of a car. I can say number of gears in our car, or I can say model of a car, etc. So there might be multiple things we can say that these are attributes of a car, or these are features of a car, or these are properties of a car. Similarly, a car could perform certain things. A car could perform certain tasks. So we will call these tasks as behavior of car. So what could be a behavior of a car? Like I want to accelerate the car, so it could be one of the behavior. Or I want to stop the car, that could be another behavior of a car. Or I can say that we want to decelerate the car, it could be another behavior of a car. So basically, when we are trying to define an object, we say that it consists of attributes and behavior, and it's a real world entity. So when we say real world entity, that you can imagine that there is something, there is some object or there is some body that is taking some space. Let us see here. Just imagine this box. When you talk about an object, just imagine this box and try to see these two things. One is attribute and behavior that is wrapped inside this thing, this box. So this will make up an object. As we are seeing the example of car, this thing you see here, I have drawn a car. Although my drawing is not that good, but I have tried to draw a car here, or I can say that I am trying to draw a car with its attributes and with its behavior. Because if you want to use a car, you first should have a drawing for that. So first you should have a drawing of car, or I can say engineering drawing of a car, and then you get real car, right? Another example we can take, that you have a prototype of a building, and then there is some real building. So what do we understand here? We are seeing two things. One is a drawing or prototype things, and another is real world thing. So in terms of object oriented programming system, this drawing is called class, or this prototype is called class, or I can say this prototype or blueprint, this is called class. The thing that we are getting in real, in terms of OOPS, we call it object. So one difference is clear, that if we are drawing something that we have seen here, this drawing is called class, and if we could implement this thing into real world, that will be called an object. So a class, something that is not real, but an object is real, right? So try to take few more examples, so that we can understand it clearly, that what do we mean by object and what we mean by class. So first try to take example of class. So it could be blueprint of a building, or design of a watch, or I can say code of Windows, or code of Linux, etc. Right? So these things are including blueprints, designs, and the code. Especially I have said here, that means we are defining what are Windows or Linux are going to, what are Linux or Windows going to be, what features they will include, what action they will perform. We are going to define that inside that code. And when we talk about object for these things, I will write below this, so that it is easier to understand. When I am talking about blueprint of a building in a class, and it comes to the real world, it will be called an object. So this will be real building. Similarly, when I am talking about design of a car, design of a watch, then a real watch will be called object. If I am talking about code of Windows, here we are going to define these behaviors or these attributes of Windows, and when we implement it in real world or send the copies to users, so that is an object of window, or I can say that real Windows OS we get. Similarly for Linux system, it's real Linux operating system we get. So I think we are clear that anything that is real, that will be called object. And if you are going to define, or we are going to talk about the blueprint or prototype or designing of something, that will be called class. One more important thing that I want to discuss is about this process. This process of conversion from class to object is called instantiation. Conversion from class to object. In other terms, we can also say that an object is an instance of a class. So the most important point here is, we can have one class, suppose class car, and we can generate multiple cars from that car. I can say that my car, one object I am generating from that, your car, we are generating different car from the same blueprint or same design. You must have seen that there are two cars which are exactly same, but we have the same blueprint. And in case or in term of OOPS, we will say that we have defined that car or we have made a design once, but we can generate multiple objects from that. An object will be called instance of the class, and the class will be something from which we generate object. So I think, guys, it is clear that what do you mean by object and what do you mean by class. And we will try to wind up this lecture here. If you have any queries or any questions, please put it in the comments, and I will try to revert back. Thank you so much.